much methodology was firstly investigated by a study that we conducted in the city of Thessaloniki using questionnaire data and by applying the analytical hierarchy process method. And as you can see, the results in this table, delayed passings are by far the most annoying type of event, both for pedestrians and cyclists. So the question that our presentation now aims to respond is, can we consider global the event weights that we computed in the city of Thessaloniki? Or these weights vary from country to country or even from city to city? And I have to say here that it is very important to establish global weights in order to facilitate engineers and policymakers in applying methodologies and tools by not making necessary for them to concentrate additional data. This time we focused on via Makeda search space. It was also mentioned in the previous presentation. It is located downtown in Palermo, Italy, and it's a very important street which hosts many cyclists and pedestrians on a daily basis. We used a similar questionnaire as in the case of Thessaloniki, using pairwise comparisons, and we carried out the survey through face-to-face interviews for more than 1 month period. We finally concentrated 275 questionnaires for pedestrians and 210 questionnaires from cyclists. Regarding the descriptive statistics for pedestrians, we can see a balance between males and females and also a good distribution among all age classes. Regarding the level of service that pedestrians perceive in Via Makeda, the most frequent answer was level of service D, but we also had many respondents perceiving a lower level of service, namely E or F. Concerning cyclists, here we don't have a balance between male and female. Males were 71.4% of our sample, and this is very frequent in countries and cities with not so advanced cyclist culture. 51% were aged between 54 and 64 years old, and here we can see an extremely negative assessment of the Via Makeda street by cyclists. No cyclist perceived the level of service A or B, while 95% of cyclists perceived a level of service E or F, which is unacceptable. Let's go to the core of our analysis, which is the assignment of the weights. We applied the AHP method in order to be consistent with the survey in Thessaloniki, but there are also some alternatives. And we included 8 pairwise comparisons in each questionnaire and the additional necessary pairwise comparisons that were not included in the questionnaire were computed through the transitivity rule. And here we can see the weights that derived for the case of Palermo. Here we can see that delayed passings are not so annoying for pedestrians and cyclists as in the case of Thessaloniki. But since the time is limited, let's go to the conclusions where we can see the comparison between the two cities. We identified both similarities and both differences. The first similarity is that pedestrians tend to be more annoyed by interactions which involve cyclists, while cyclists tend to be more annoyed by interactions which involve pedestrians. Maybe that sounds surprising to someone, since we thought that cyclists will cause the most negative impact due to their increased mass and their increased speed. But we see that cyclists are mostly annoyed by pedestrians who have a more unpredictable movement. Also, from both studies, we can say that body mass assumption cannot be considered valid, at least for the case of Thessaloniki and Palermo, since passings and meetings have approximately the same negative impact. On the other hand, the most important difference between the two cities was that delayed passings is indeed an undesired event, but in the case of Palermo, it was not assessed so negatively as in the case of Thessaloniki. Concluding, we see that the comparison between the two cities provides some evidence about establishing some standard values. And the conduction of similar studies in the future in other cities could result in some globalized values or in some values that are well adapted to some clusters of cities which share common characteristics regarding their mobility, the mobility attitudes and habits of the users and the infrastructure characteristics. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Andreas, for this interesting presentation. Are there any questions from the participants or from someone who is watching and want to ask any question from through the chat? Okay, thank you, Andreas, very much.
Thank you.
And now let's move on to the third presenter, who is Mr. Professor Panagiotis Papaioannou. The title of his presentation is Shared Mobility and Last Mile Connectivity to Metro Public Transport, Survey Design Aspects for Determining Willingness for Intermodal Ride Sharing in Athens. Professor Papaioannou, you have the floor.
Thank you, Yanis. I don't know if I have shared my screen. Can you see that?
No.
Can you see? No? Share your screen. I just press share. Okay. Okay, thank you very much. I'm really glad I'm with you. My presentation is about shared mobility and last mile connectivity to metro public transport, and it's about the survey design aspects for determining willingness for intermodal ride sharing in Athens. It's a long title, but I hope I'll explain it. The aim of the presentation is first to present the design aspects of a combined revealed preference, stated preference survey for determining the prospective willingness of public transit, the public transport, metro and suburban rail commuters towards becoming carpoolers for the first or last mile of their trip. So maintaining the main commuting trip with public transport, metro or suburban rail, but replacing the first or last mile with carpooling. And to demonstrate the main issues associated with carpooling and carpoolers and take them into account when designing the proper policies for promoting this carpooling option. Now, a few words about the main facts we are dealing with. We know from experience and bibliography that in areas where there is a low density of inhabitants and commuters, and there is rail transport, there is no high demand for this transport because people prefer to use their car. So if there is either poor public transport by bus, poor feeder services, or congested park and ride facilities at the hubs, people will not prefer this option to go there and take the train or the suburban rail. Now, carpooling, we know it's an efficient mobility form which may fill service gaps in certain cases. We know carpooling in the States and in other countries where the trips are long and there is a problem with public transit, but this is not the case in our case. And finally, the intermodal hubs are critical components for carpooling in most rail system. Now, this research study is within the framework of a European project, Ride to Rail, and which is a big European project, but in the case of Athens, which is one of the case studies in the project, the Attico Metro is the responsible partner who is responsible for public transport provision by Metro in Athens, and they are thinking of applying policies to promote carpooling for the last and first mile, and they would like also to develop a ride matching application combining flexible and scheduled mobility services. Now, the objective of this study is, among others, to enhance the understanding of travelers' decision using carpooling to access or ingress these intermodal hubs. Let's see the study area. This is in suburban Athens. You see the two areas is the Kisis Plakedias station, which serves both metro and suburban rail. These are two different operators, but they share the same infrastructure. And the second is Koropi Metro Suburban Rail Public Transport Intermodal Hub. So here is Athens. The route of the metro is like this and is going to the airport, and the other suburban route is like this. So people in those areas, they could well get the metro or the suburban here to go to their destination, but because there is no, let's say, availability at the parking hubs for parking in some cases, or they don't want to pay the parking fee on the second one, they prefer perhaps to get their car and go directly to their final destination. Now, here we can see the level of the existing rail PT services. So we have metro and suburban. In the morning peak, we have five passages every. The suburban at the Kisis Plakedias every 5 minutes. The metro and every 20, the suburban, so the combined frequencies every 4 minutes. And on the other one, which is far away, more or less close to the airport, is every 30 minutes the metro, and every 20 minutes the suburban, the same, and every 12 minutes the combined. The span of services is from 5:30 to 23 or 24. You see that this is the number of morning peak boardings as have been, recorded by Attico Metro surveys. Regarding park and ride facilities, there are 630 spaces at Kisis Plakedias, the one which is closer to Athens, but there is a fee, which is 0.5 euro per hour up to 12 hours per day. For the other one is free. So here there is availability of spaces, and here there is shortages of spaces. So we have the two extremes. Now, regarding the survey design, this will be a combined revealed and stated preference. With the revealed preference, we'll record the behavior of the respondents. So current preferences, why they take this mode of transport, when they travel, how often, and so on. And also what is the cost, either actual or perceived. And then there will be some socioeconomic feature recorded, and the SP Games cards, which will be addressed, all of them to four different groups: public transport, feeder bus passengers, driving alone, driving with others, HOV, users, and riding as car passenger, not driver. So these four different groups. Here there are the number of choice sets that can be examined through the SP design. So this is the actual travel option: feeder bus, solo driver, high occupancy vehicle driver, and car passengers. And the alternative options that will be examined, so three options in total, will be either as a carpool driver or as a carpool rider. And here, of course, the driver can be only rider as alternative option, and here only as driver. And here is the sample size requirements, the number of questions that will be gathered from each group. This is a more or less a quota type sampling. And here we go to the travel option attributes. This is the most, let's say, hard part. So for each alternative, existing one, we have the attributes that will be either recorded or taken from the metro, like time or whatever, from the model and from the actual data. And here we have the reference value and the variations, low, medium, or high. And similarly for driving alone, the attributes, the levels, and so on, and all the explanations are given below. And here again for car rider, the options, carpool driver, the options. Here we explain how the travel time and travel cost is calculated, what are the components of each attribute, and how these are being calculated. Finally, it's important to mention that for carpoolers in the examined options, there will be the guaranteed rent home possibility if nobody can take them for the carpool trip back. They could get either a paid bus ticket for bus or get a taxi, and this will be happened given a certain possibility that this problem will happen. And of course there are minus and plus variations from the medium level and so on. Now, given that the combinations are too many, the full factorial design would yield 5,832 combinations. We go to a fractional factorial design that would result to 24 combinations, and this is done by using the R program, the R suite, using random selection. And also we are using three blocks, splitting the 24 into three blocks of eight. So each question person will have to respond to eight games. And these are the options, high level, level, and so on. So this is, let's say, the design, the full design of the survey. Now I'm coming to the last one. So once the survey will be over, there will be, of course, pilot survey and so on. Then we are going to develop discrete choice models for testing specific policies regarding the travelers. So what will happen if you have a free parking or if you have a reduced fare and so on, to see which policy will be more effective based on the different models that will address the different commuter groups. And as I say here, discounted fee, value of providing a guarantee at home, and value of providing carpool matching service. So that's all very quickly. Sorry for taking a couple of minutes of your time. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Professor Papaioannou, for this presentation. And this is a very interesting topic of the last mile. And
I would like also to thank Mr. De Lucas and Mr. Yoriadis, the co-authors, for this effort.
Okay. Any question? Okay. Let's move on to the last presenter, who will be Tiziana. It will be you.
Yes.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yeah. We can hear you.
Okay. Did you see my screen? Did you see my screen?
No.
No, that's yeah. No?
we're adjusting. It's okay.
Okay. The main objective of this research is the first analysis of considering before and after approach conducted through a sample of inhabitants of the city of Enna in order to understand if the car and bus sharing service implemented has a positive response in this town. A bottom-up approach has been used in order to encourage participatory planning, democratic planning, that involves the citizen and allows to remodulate the service, especially in the negative point, in order not to encourage the use of private vehicles. Speaking on shared mobility, it's necessary to remember what is defined by the spectrum made by Aviver 2020 about different types of shared mobility. In the national context, the data for 2018-2019 show not equal distribution, both from the spatial point of view, with a difference between north, south, and central region of Italy. And also, as can be seen in the second graph, a diversification of shared service with an higher value of bike sharing, such as described on light blue. The national trend, the Italian trend, show that the typical user is male with age between 30-39 here. The younger users is linked to electric vehicle with age less than 30 here. The methodology adopted considered the comparison of the opinion of the sample of inhabitants, the same sample before and after, with over 30 years of age, in order to evaluate the difference between the answers given to a customer administered before and after the event of current bond sharing service in Enna. The main step of this analytic study is the identification of the problem to be monitored, in this case, urban care and bond sharing mobility, the choice population with a particular sample of citizens with more than 30 here living in Enna, data collection, data analysis, and interpretation. The sample users was characterized by 370 units, about 5% of population over 30, and 20% of Enna drivers. The data acquisition was made online and face-to-face survey. About the period before evaluation is related to February-March 2018. In April 2019 start car bond sharing service in Enna, and the after evaluation was conducted in October-December 2019. About the survey section, we defined three different tables, three different parts, socioeconomic data, variables such as gender, age and job, driver and car ownership, and also bike. The second part about the transport attitude related to the national and international car bar bike sharing experience. And the third part about the implementation of service considering a legal state value and six different criteria such as adventures, rates, presence of city car in the fleet, easy booking, easy search of parking, accessible vehicle for all, and high technology applied. The final part was related to the propensity to use, considering before and after event of this service in the city. Enna was located in the middle part of Sicily, on the peak of the mountain. It is characterized by three different districts, Enna Alta, that is the historical city center, Enna Bassa is the residential area, and the third is Bergusa, like touristic area. To 27,000 inhabitants plus 8,000 students, university students. The main transport was characterized by private vehicle and local buses. The train station is about 6 kilometers far from the center and 1 hour from the main airport of Catania. About the sample, the main percentage was male with adult age, active worker, for 59%, and the main is related to the freelance job. About the driving activities, the sample was characterized from driving license for 68%, about the driving experience over 20 years, More than 25% was characterized in this sample. About the ownership, 80% of sample have a car, as a car, and 25% as a bike. About Italian and French experience, about shared mobility, we observe the main percentage about bike, with 49 in Italian experience and 53 and 55 in French experience. Considering car sharing results, the investigation has shown that the criteria of the advantageous rate of simple parking and accessibility of vehicle flow have suffered a reduction in value on scale from 0 to 2. Therefore, the current service has this critical issue to solve. An improvement in judgment after implementation has only been in the ease of booking. Equal values was given before and after considering the technologies of service vehicles, as well as the presence of a small car in the fleets. About the van sharing results, the rating of the van service registered negativity in the same criteria as this before, but an improvement in the rating after use, both for the booking and for the number of vans in the fleets. A similar value has been maintained in terms of technology, which in the fleet vehicle are equipped. Finally, the analysis has compared the propensity to use the service before and after recording a better value only in the case of van sharing, like described on orange on the first table. Therefore, the company will have to review some characteristics of the car sharing service in order to make it performing and suitable to the local transport demo. This analysis is also necessary before an electric bike service is inserted. The improvement of the different components of the service will be able to encourage the use of sustainable mobility by the citizens of Enna. In conclusion, a bottom-up approach for car and van sharing service judgments was conducted, considering a before and after analysis. This cross-sectional analysis confirmed the need of participatory planning and democratic action in order to optimize and mitigate the negative point relating to the transport decision. The first results about citizen opinion show the opinion about the implementation of this service in the mountain time. The improvement of car sharing was related to the cost reduction, especially about subscription, a remodulation of the rate, a city car and manual gearbox. A positive opinion was registered about the van service, which should be improved with an increase in vehicle fleets. Like future step, expanding the sample, considering young people under 30 and university students, and also considering the electric bike sharing that will be in August of this year. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Tiziana, for this presentation. Are there any questions? Okay. So if there are any no question, I would like to thank you all for being in this second slot of the AMOS virtual workshop. I would like to thank the presenters for putting the time limits. And also I would like to invite you to the third slot, which will be starting about 20 minutes with the presentation.
Yanis, this is Panos, and we hope that we'll be able next time to get together to make presentations with physical presence.
Of course. This was a wish in my starting speech. So, thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Penso avrebbero sentito lì ognuna, come si suol dire, mentre... Cioè, ma meno male che mi è venuto in mente di togliermi la dentro.
Live streaming is on.
Okay, in a few minutes we can start a new session. We are waiting the chairman. He's present.
Yes, I'm here.
Okay.
We can start?
If you want, we can start.
Okay. You are welcome to the third section of AMUS, the third slot. The AMUS workshop now ends with the featuring two presentations. I invite Lazaros Apostolidis to introduce the work entitled iChange, a platform for managing dockless bike sharing system. Lazaro, please.
Hi, do you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Do you see my screen?
Yeah.
So we are ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. So I'm Lazaros, as Diana said. I am from ITI of Center of Research and Technology in Greece. I represent a group of people from ITI, Aristotle University, and a local company called Brainbox. Together, we have built a platform for managing dockless bike sharing systems. We called it iChange, and this is what I'm about to present to you. iChange is built to serve both users and administration needs, and also to fulfill research needs by offering the data of the routes through an API. It's built to provide motivations to citizens to use the bicycles instead of private cars for daily commuting, and to change the ownership approach and promote the approach of sharing. For the system architecture now, as I have said, we are talking about dockless bike systems. So the citizen can start a terminator and at any point design the large predefined geofenced area. For this purpose, every bicycle has integrated in their frame a GPS device that is able to transmit the exact location of the bicycle, a GPS card to transmit over the network this information, and the controller, which is responsible for actions on the bike, like locking and unlocking it on demand. The exact location of bicycle and combined with timestamp are periodically sent over the network and stored in system servers, and there are enriched with data from external APIs like weather data. Also offered an admin dashboard for the admin, and for the research community, an API for accessing the store data. To interact with the system and the bicycles, we have developed an app for smartphone. It's called Easy Move GR. And it's accessible both for iOS and Android through App Store and Google Play. And through the app, you can create an account, log in, log out. It's a map with the exact location of the bicycles is offered. You can unlock and lock a bicycle, see the history of rentals and payments, top up your account, modify your account, or report problems in bicycles. Also, traffic micro-based data are integrated in the platform. With the help of PTV Visum software and the four-step travel demand model, we have divided the area that the system is established in more than 300 traffic zones. And we provide to the citizen a time and cost comparison between the ride that made with a bicycle of the system and the same that the with a car, a bus, or by walk. Also, we have implemented an interactive map which shows information that it's relative to the user current location. The information includes the location of iChange bicycle, of the system bicycles, alternative transportation like bus stop or bus line, weather forecast, infrastructure, and points of interest that are relevant to the user's current location. Also, with data processing, we can offer to the administrator more information, like a spatial analysis of the rent starting points location, combined with clustering, or time analysis of rents, also in 24 hours format, or daily, in 7 days of the week. For the admin, we also provide a dashboard that shows information about the system, more specific for general statistics, completed orders, information about the system bicycles, registered users and the users of the API, social media content, and some notifications. For the research community, we have developed an API so that to provide access to the data coming from the interaction of the system and the rights. The access is controlled. You have to use the API. You have to register and get a valid API key. There's rate limit. And there are two main calls that the API serves. The first one is for searching orders, matching specific criteria. And the second one is when you want to get the trajectory points of a specific route. The data that we offer through the API is anonymized in order to protect the users and not reveal private information about them. The platform and chains also implements a framework for social media monitoring. The administration can set a list of keywords relevant to a topic, and the tool gathers all content that it's posted to social media seconds to minutes after their publication. So for future work, we are planning to implement bicycle pre-booking, gamification services, increase the use for recreation, tourism, or for commuting, access bicycles for special bicycles for people with disabilities or limitations, or electric bicycles to access areas with high altitude, and to provide plans for rebalancing the bikes and a plan for maintenance. And this is pretty much the platform. Thank you for your attention and your time.
Okay, thank you, Lazarus. Okay. Any question? Just a curiosity. Who is the main user of this shared service in your town, in your city?
I mean, what is the main user? The citizens of the city, anyone can rent a bike. It's free for everyone. Everyone just create an account through the app and can use the bicycle.
Okay. Is there special rates for tourists?
No, but it's an action that we want to promote in the summer where the tourist is in higher demand. So it's a future action.
Okay.
It's not just for tourism, it's for everyone, for every citizen or visitor or anyone else.
Thank you for your reply. Any question? Other question? Okay. I invite now Nahid to show the research conducted in collaboration between the University of Annakore and the University of British Columbia, titled Bivariate Analysis of the Influencing Factor of the Upcoming Personal Mobility Vehicle in Palermo. Nahid, are you ready?
Yes, I'm here. Do you hear me?
Yep.
Okay, let me see how to figure out my screen. I think am I being seen here?
Okay.
All right. Very good morning. I'm from Canada here in morning, and I'm sure there is the evening. My name is Nahid. I'm from UBC, University of British Columbia in Canada. I'm today here to present research with my colleagues. Tixiana, Dario, and Giovanni. The thing I'm going to go today in a matter of short span time to let you understand that how personal mobility vehicles has been an important factor and also is going to be an emerging challenges as well in the city of Palermo. So the thing is important here, you know, because even though the presence has been quite a bit of low in the city of Palermo, but definitely given the trend of increase, there's a chance that it might be a good understanding that how this is going to be a mode of transportation for work and also recreational purposes. So typically, the thing it has been done for micromobility, you know, it has certain restrictions when it comes to transit. At the same time, you know, it is mostly being used when there is a congestion or something to avoid those problematic areas, and then also to avoid the case for parking facility where there is a need for payment. Typically, a personal mobility vehicle is characterized by a technology-driven innovations. At the same time, you know, there is a need for regulations, which might be important to understand how they are safely being mobiled within the city or even across the cities within a certain region. So the thing is that has been happened back in Italy. The legislation has been there, but definitely the way it has been operationalized is not to the extent that is more to the part of safety operations and catering the need of the people who would like to travel a long distance. In our research, we had a few steps that we have followed. The thing we have done, we have tried to understand the attitudes and perceptions of the user, that how they understand about micromobility when it comes to within the city mobility. And the sample was taken in collaboration with a nonprofit association. The thing is important here to understand that what are the socioeconomic variables that are important and which might affect the propensity and also the safety perceptions that are associated with PMB kind of issues. Back in Italy, that thing is quite important to see because the city of Palermo is a very tourist attraction for so many reasons. And mostly people come here for recreation and vacation purposes. At the same time, if you look at the kind of current presence of PMB across the city, they're mostly in the form of e-bike, scooters, mopeds, or sometimes you can see their like hoverboard, monowheels, and so on. The question could be, once you see those presence and also they're emerging across cities, the question could be, how much regulations are there in place to make sure they have certain control over their mobility versus how they can ensure safety? For example, you can see here that they have certain regulations which dictate the speed limit for certain PMV. At the same time, they also takes into consideration that if there is any training or what are the age limit involved, those were actual users of those PMV. But again, you know, this is very much at the initial stage, and there is a much more need there to be developed and further grown from there. As you see, the city of Palermo is definitely a big city with an inhabitants of more than 600,000 populations. The question could be, you know, that given this very much emerging tourists versus in-city dwellers, how we understand the need within the city versus the growing demand for it. The way it is now, it is very much also scant in terms of presence. Only a few companies who are offering, you know, those kind of services who would like to avail and travel within the city or across the cities. When it comes to sampling variables, we have taken into consideration a few of the important variables. I'll go through with them to make sure you understand what we have meant and dealt with those. We took into consideration gender, for example, that if gender has any kind of influence over the choice versus safety perception. Also, look into the age, job, meaning that if they are freelancer versus if they are engaged with job. At the same time, we also look into consideration like transport attitude, because when you are on travel on a certain mode, the important question could be how safety they are. And then if there's an accident history being involved in that mode of transportation, right? So we have taken all this into consideration with a certain sample survey, and we collected about 133 interviews, which is through a non-profit association, and they helped us a lot in terms of getting data that how we can understand these variables and that effect onto the usage of PMV. The crux of the issue here is that if you look at all those variables versus their perception, safety conditions, and also the propensity to use for PMV, one thing is very interesting here that mostly the user of those PMV are men, like man in the world, and they are somewhere employed or freelance workers. And the staggering thing here is that the age cohort has been found that 28 to 45 age groups are the mostly users of this PMV. And if you look at the time that they're using it for, it's less than a year, because even though people have the propensity, they have the demand for it, but you know, the number of years being used is quite low, which is less than a year. This is the kind of key part of the research, is that you know, there is a strong gender heterogeneity when it comes to the usage of a PMV. And we have seen that, given the sample we had, only 68% male use PMV versus 32% are women. So there's a gap of gender in there. At the same time, because if even though Palermo is a city where you may expect a lot more tourists coming in and they're staying there, but mostly they are the residents that they use that use those PMV. And on the other hand, as I mentioned earlier, the age group wise, only 28 to 45 age groups are the most users of this PMV. So there is still a pervasive gap of other age groups who might be also the users of PMV. And the question could be then that if we have much higher user, then how we can possibly make sure they are safe and also there are regulations in place for them to move around. When it comes to let's say motivations of daily commuting, we have seen that mostly people are using for their work kind of commute, and there are a few for also recreation purposes like free time roaming around, and also fewer only going for schooling purposes along with PMV. And then as far as transport mode and ownership is concerned, even though many people have car and also other kind of vehicles, they also still use PMV, but again, sometimes the infrastructure is a problem itself because they don't allow them to use, in a way that is safety and at the same time cater their needs when it comes to commuting to work and other purposes. The second part of the interview was about how we have, assigned the distance itself with the PMV. And we have seen that in 60% cases, they go actually six kilometers, which is not quite short though. At the same time, 35% journey are happening only within 3 kilometers. It shows that, even though people have propensity, but still they're not really going that long for certain mode of travel and also their purposes. And that thing is also interesting here because we have also gathered the perception that how they understand different variables which might affect their choice over PMV. And there are many important factors we have figured out that, let's say, for example, safety on board has been found to be one of the important factors that might influence their choice. Savings when it comes to money with the transportation, meaning that they are not falling into congestions and also all other kind of challenges that we may see in typical car or bus kind of mode of transportations, right? And there is also one important factor. We have found that infrastructure, which is not yet in place there, and that is one of the barriers that might cause them not to choose PMV over other mode of transportations. This is a very interesting part, I would like to share with you, is that we have found that age and job, these are the two important factors that are significant. At the same time, they are very much associated with the perceptions when it comes to savings, when it comes to safety on board. At the same time, how they are choosing actually those PMV in favor of their either daily work or recreations or some other purposes. So basically, job and age has been found to be significant in regard to those variables. On the other hand, we have seen that, for example, moving reason, meaning that if I would like to go from my point A to Z, then the question could be, why do I go there? So if I see that reason, definitely that reason wise, we haven't found significant relationship with the reason of travel versus the mode of choice as PMV in the daily mode. Just to conclude with a few words. Definitely this is the first of its kind study that has been carried out in Palermo. So there is much more need to be done as we go along with the time and passage. But one thing is very important here is that if you'd like to let the city grow in a way, meaning that if you invite more tourists, more people to live in and so on, the question could be how we offer more choices of mode of transportations. which might make the mobility easier and safer and also much more faster than other modes. So definitely this study is kind of just the foundation of that kind of directions. And there is much more need to be done in the coming days to see how much we can do and also put place the regulations in place. At the same time, you know, what the infrastructure would be needed that would be helping a lot in terms of catering those needs that we expect in the coming years. Definitely we had limitations of survey because the survey sample was quite small and we didn't have a chance to take a representation of survey sample, but definitely as you go along, we can have better sample size to understand what is the nature of problem and propensity. So we can you know, understand this phenomenon to design, number one, regulations, number two, how to influence infrastructure, at the same time, how to really understand those, let's say, age cohort-driven demands that you may expect in the coming years. I think with that kind of synopsis, I'm done here.
Okay.
I'll be happy to have some questions if you have.
Okay, thank you for your presentation, Naid. Any question? I want to thank to all participants of the third slot in order to participate to AMOS conference. I hope that the interesting topic and highlights will be working together in common research. I completed. It's all.
Okay. Thank you very much, Etul. I remember to chairman to compile the evaluation form. And if there are not any questions, we can close this section.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Etul.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.